Hi guys, and I don't know, shall I say welcome to the most important bit film I've made, maybe ever made, about the precision and consistency in instinctive archery. Well, you who follow me know that I've been shooting like 23 years plus, and what could I say, the last month or two I've really been focusing on boning out what gives me the consistency, because it's actually like this, that if you've been shooting for some years and sometimes you hit that spot exactly, I mean now and then, well, then you actually have precision, because you're able to do that. So when you do everything right, you hit the exact spot you're looking at. So in fact, you actually have precision. Now what you're lacking is consistency. That is just doing the same thing, hitting that spot more often, preferably every time, because kind of that's what we want. So if you hit your spot now and then, you've got precision. So what you need is consistency. And although many balls are really good, I have to say that to get that perfect consistency, well, the best consistency you can't have, I have to say that you need a ball like this. Because what this ball actually does is that it allows me to have my arrow in the exact middle of the bow, and well, now you're thinking, so what? But the thing is that, because, well, the string is going, when I release the string, it's going right towards the riser and limbs in the middle. So my power stroke is in the middle of the bow. So if I put my arrow just exactly behind that, I'm going to get most of the power to the arrow, and it is also going to be more forgiving. And I mean sideways, because it's in the middle. Up and down, well, that's just about how the arrow shelf is made, so it allows the arrow to move like this if you do some faulty or different pressure points on your handle. But the main thing sideways is the absolute center shot cut shelf that this Acadian has, because it does kind of the same thing for as this does, but sideways, because it's not biased to left or right, it's in the exact middle, so it's going to be more forgiving because it has more power coming from the ball pushing it, so it's a bit more forgiving for wrong hand placements, because that is one thing we're gonna all fight against. That's our hand placement, because we're standing awkwardly and differently in the forest. We get different pressure points, and therefore we also miss. And the release is the thing that never gonna leave us. That is something we're gonna fight against for all our lives. So, but that's just the interesting bit. If it would be too easy, would be no fun to do it. So if you got a bow like this, and it really doesn't matter, it kind of whatever bow you have, because if we are looking at how our eyes and how our brain adjust and kind of gives us consistency, putting the arrow where we want it every time. So there's been a lot of talking about this. This is the left eye and this is the right eye. I don't actually No, if you see that,
maybe I have to zoom. Yeah, that was a crappy picture. Try to get the whole thing in the big jar. Sorry about this, guys.
So, there's been a lot of emphasis, even from me, about this getting the arrow in the middle of. So, if this is your eyes, kind of. Getting the arrow, the point in the middle of your eyes. So that means that the arrow comes here from sideways somehow. Because, well, we can't put our arm there and hold like this in the middle of our eyes. Doesn't work. And still, because, well, just not working. So we have to anchor sideways. Going from this and all this that I've been talking about, man, that's really hard and difficult, and it puts a strain on your neck. And what it actually does is that this sideways motion, it pushes the arrow more against one eye, and that'd be the right eye for me because I'm a right-hand shooter. But then you see this elbow is not here, it's coming there. So guys, forget everything I said before, forget everything you heard, read, or anything. The thing is that this works fine for yardage estimation. We need this. We need to have both eyes, both sides of the target. That's why we look at something like this. That's why our eyes are here. They are not like this. So, the brain with the eyes yardage estimates how far away it is. So, yes, we need that because of this. But I actually found out that, well, this straightening up, trying to, it kind of gives you bad releases and kind of messes too much with your shooting. So, sorry about that, guys, but stop doing that. What we need to do, actually, is we need to have a bit of a side view against the target.
I hope you see that. I just have to check that. So, yep.
Because what I'm meaning by that is going from straight to a little bit angled view. Because what we actually need to do is to get this arrow to become to be an extension of our sight line from our right eye. And the thing is the dominant we've been talking about, and actually I don't think it does that much, because even if it's not your dominant eye, you're going to see the arrow and the target kind of the same way. The most important thing here is that we don't see the arrow sideways anymore. We see the arrow coming straight towards the target, with the line going right through our right eye. So from this strange we go up here, so we look at it sideways. And to be able to do that, we can't really stand very straight. Well, you can, but it's not ultimate. You need to kind of bend a bit, both with your hip and your head. So you kind of put your eyes, your head above your arrow and your anchor. So, you're getting what I'm drifting at. So if I close my left eye here, I can see with my right eye the arrow pointing exactly towards my target. And in this case, that being my right eye on the screen there. So this is what guides our arrow. So if we have this yardage estimation straightforwards, but as long as we don't turn our head too much, we still have this yardage estimation going on, still working. But if you look at shoot like this, you're not going to guide the arrow properly. You need to tilt your bow and get your arrow through the line sight of your right eye. As I'm a right shooter. If I shoot left, it's my left eye. So, and I found out that that is the secret with one more thing. But okay, it comes naturally if you do it like this, because if you put your arrow underneath your eye, because that's the secret, you need it underneath, kind of, you need to kind of look over the arrow. So you need to have your anchor low and be over the arrow with your eyes. Because if you go up here, so you kind of anchor beside you, like here, it's not gonna work. Forget it. What you could do here is that you tilt so much that you get the arrow still straight against. So you can overcome that problem if you have a very sideways anchoring position just by tilting. You get my drift? So you go from this sideways, that's not good, by tilting. So you come above the arrow, get your anchor underneath your eyes. And there you have it. Now my arrow is underneath my eyes, pointing straight towards the target. So what you could actually do, even if we are instinctive archers that we don't look at our arrow, is that when you come up to your first shot of today, and that should be 5 meters with a bare shaft, as I've been pointing out so many times, I still doesn't do it myself, but that would be the best way. You should close your left eye, guys, and see that your arrow is going from this point straight towards your target. Because if you see your arrow sideways, then you know something's wrong. Either you're anchoring wrong, too much up here, you have a too straight position, so you don't anchor above the arrow, you anchor beside the arrow. And then you can see the arrow goes like this, instead of straight. And I have been actually shooting like this for many, many years, and it works, but it's really, really hard psychologically to remain that position. Because if you look at the arrow, it's gonna look like it's going bonkers, man. I've been talking about that in previous films. And I would say, if I knew this from the beginning, I wouldn't have started shooting like this. And the thing is that I am a little bit puzzled if I actually have done that. Because it's just something that I thought that I have been doing. Because, well, I had such a wonderful consistency when I started shooting with my recurve like 20 years ago. And I really don't think that I could have that if I'm looking at the arrow sideways. Because I really need to have the arrow straight against my target to get that consistency. And I would say that is that's the secret. That's it, man. If I just do that, man, my consistency is so incredibly good. It's sick, man. So, okay, then I have shoot in all those yardages also, so over the years, so I can shoot with consistency for a lot of different yardages. I mean, I shoot 40, 50 meters on a stump. I hit every time, 3 arrows, so. But that's just the yardage estimation. But to get that consistency, that sideways precision. Yeah, I absolutely need to get my arrow straight against the target on my right eye sight line. That's it. That's actually so incredibly easy. So now when I've been out shooting and I'm doing those crappy sideways shots, man, I can fix that so easily, man. Because I just go up and I probably stand like this. If I close that eyes, my left eye, I can see my arrow coming from here and going the wrong angle. So if I just close my eye and see this, man, I'm doing something wrong. I need to tilt, bend more, so I get the arrow straight against the target. And bam, I'm back. It's that easy. It's so incredibly easy. So yes, you need to have a bit of an angled view against the target. By that I'm meaning not straight, you need to have a bit angled view. And you need to be tilting. Because, okay, you can stand straight and just bend your neck a bit like this. It actually works quite good as I'm standing now, and it kind of feels quite comfortable. And Peter shoots like this, and well, he actually does the same thing as I do, but because I just bend my body to, I don't need to bend my neck that much, so maybe I just bend my neck half of what Peter does, because I bend my body too. So if you can see, if Peter shoots like this, I can raise my head a bit and tilt my body instead. So I'm still in the same position. But it feels so much better for my neck. I'm getting a neck pain if I go straight shooting and doing this. Probably because I'm getting old. I don't know. But I've been talking about that so many times, that you should shoot as it feels comfortable for you. But this is what gives you accuracy. This is the secret. That's it. Point on, man. This is it. I was talking about that secret before. I wanted to hold my courses and I'm going to reveal the secret. But this is it. This is it, guys. I'm giving it to you because, well, so many of you did so much for me with the gift to PayPal. And, man, I feel that, hey, I don't want to hold anything back. I want to give you this for free, man. Because that is what I was intending to do from the beginning. I just wanted to make a living out of archery. I need a little bit secret to reveal, kind of. But okay, this is it, guys. I'm giving it to you. This is the secret to, not precision, but precision too, but absolutely consistency. Because as I said, every now and then most of us hit the spot. So we kind of found the precision, but we lack the consistency to do that over and over again. And this is what gives you that consistency. But it's kind of very easy when you start thinking about it. It's like if we change this to a rifle, man. Of course you need to have your barrel straight against the target. How else are you gonna hit? You can put your rifle down here and think you're gonna instinctively adjust it. And with a rifle it would just be like 1 or 2 millimeters like this. It's not gonna work, man. You could probably get nearby a lot of times, but not the perfect consistency that you actually can have if you just put your arrow straight against the target underneath your right eye. That's it, nothing else. Everything I said before, forget it, man. Between your eyes, that's still between your eyes. But you need to turn your head a bit. Now, of course I said that you can't stand like this when you're shooting. But if you go too much sideways, well, your yardage estimation isn't gonna work. So yeah, you need to find a point. But if you go too much and you look down at your arrow, you can see that, no, that's not working, man. So it's quite an easy way to know that you're doing right, just close your left eye, man. First shot you do, take up your ball, close your first shot. Do you see the arrow coming crooked from the side? You're doing something wrong. And what you're doing wrong then is that you have your anchor point too much to the side of you, or you're having a too straight position, like an Olympic shooter, because they shoot with sights. But if you just then have your eyes closed and you just tilt your head now, you can see that if you do this. That's it. It's so easy. My arrow actually goes from here to straight against the target, just by tilting my head. And if you do like me, just tilt just a little and tilt your body too. And I think it feels comfortable. I have a very steady stand when I stand like this. But actually, I mean, I can stand however when we're shooting. And it doesn't actually do anything. How? It doesn't matter. As long as you do this thing that you're tilting so you get the arrow underneath your eye. Man, that's it. That's the secret to precision and consistency in traditional instinctive archery. Well, even a compound bow. Not only traditional, but instinctive archery. That's it. You need to get your arrow underneath your eye, straight against the target, underneath your right eye. Because that is kind of what you're doing. You're guiding sighting with your one right eye, like as you were closing your left. But the thing is that when you're putting the left eye into the equation, you get yardage estimations too. So just for pure precision, you could close your left eye and shoot like a sight shooter. Just straight arrow against the target, and you will do just fine. But your yardage estimation wouldn't work because you only have one eye. You need two eyes to triangulate how far away it is. And that is what you get when you shoot with both eyes open. So it's kind of the same thing as sighting, just that you have your left eye open and you don't look at the arrow or the bow or anything. You just look at the target and you get accustomed to shooting this way. So, I know the difficult thing would be maybe, could be a problem that the first thing you do, you look at the arrow, and that is actually wrong, but I think you could risk that, because it's so many times, I mean, if even after all these years that I go shooting, and I just stand wrong. I got this sideways look at the arrow, and that is wrong. And I mean, I still have it after 20 years plus shooting. And I shoot so much, so many arrows, and I have been shooting, that it's so easy to do, but it's so easy to correct. Just close your eye, see that you got your arrow against the target. And then you can open your left eye. And you can actually even go down again and just shoot. Because you find your position, your stand, how to do it. So if you go up, close your left eye, check the arrow, go straight. Check down the bow, stand with both eyes and shoot. That's it, guys. It's that simple. But, I mean, this information has been out there. I've been talked about it too sometimes, but it's such a small thing to do that it's easy to ignore it, because it's not a substantial thing to do. It's just this little, what? That can't do that much, but it is 100% that what gives you precision and consistency. So you need to line up the barrel against the target, not sideways to the target. It's that easy. And when you think about it, of course it is. You need to put your rifle with a barrel against the target to hit it. Man, that's it. That's it, guys. That's all you have to do. So if I think I need a tear on it, so I don't shoot the arrow through the camera or the window. So this is not working, so oh man, it just it's like it's clicking in my brain. When I got the arrow sideways to straight against the target. That's it, guys. That's the secret to consistency and precision. So that actually fixes the sideways missing. Now if you miss up or down, that is the yardage estimation, and there is no cure, I must say. There is no shortcut to that. You need to do as I've always been telling you, you need to shoot that in to your brain. By 5 meters increments all the way up to, I don't know what, 70, 80 meters, man. So you need to do that. Thousands and thousands of arrows from 5 meters, 10 meters, 15 meters, blah, blah, blah. It's going to take years. But man, when you do that, but the consistency trick, if you are an indoor competitor, shooter, archer, trail archer, instinctively, this is what's going to put you on top of the competition. Try it, guys. You might like it.
See you out there in the forest.